We are getting back into it heavy on the East Coast with the sneaker convention scene. Today we got Soul Factory Boston held at the Reggie Lewis Track and Field Center. This one-day event from 12 to 5 definitely held some awesome kicks and some good times.
What up, guys? Back up and at it. We are at Soul Factory up in Boston this weekend, and we just checked in. Got my vendor badge right there. Over in the loading lot, not the hugest venue in the world compared to what we're used to, but it's also not a small venue. It's gonna be the first show in Boston since we did SneakerCon here last year, which was obviously a crazy ass show. So this one probably gonna be a little bit more mellow, but I think it's going to be a really good one. We're gonna do our first load unloading right now, and then figure it out from there.
Taking a look, we got a couple of shoes just for display today. Got a full car. Hopefully we come home and the car is not quite so full.
Soul Factory Boston, we are all set up, ready to go. 10:45, doors are at 12. Again, a little bit of a smaller venue than what we're used to. Still got my head held high, fingers crossed. I think it's gonna be a good day.
Soul Factory Boston was held at the Reggie Lewis Track and Field Center on the indoor basketball court. This was a relatively decent sized gymnasium that was able to hold a small stage as well as 50 to 60 3-foot by 6-foot fold out vendor tables. We were able to get set up rather quickly, and we had about an hour and a half after setup before the show actually started. VIP entry was at about 11 o'clock though, so there was a small trickle in of people beginning at 11. After getting the entire stand set up, I decided to take a lap around the venue, which honestly only took a couple of minutes due to the small size. It was pretty cool to see all of the different flavors from the Northeast, but I was pretty surprised that more vendors weren't there a little bit earlier. There was still a lot of tables that hadn't been filled up by the time that the VIP line started up. Since it didn't seem like it was too crazy with customers, I decided to give some highlights to some of the other vendor booths around because there were some absolutely amazing displays.
Yo, no way. This is like one of the cleanest pairs I've seen in a real long time. I'm surprised at how well it's held on to the blue, honestly.
After meeting your sneaker plug and Wolf's kicks, I stopped by the booth directly to their left where a specific pair caught my eye.
Quads, huh?
Yeah, trying to bring out some different stuff for these kids.
They don't get it. Nah. They don't get it, man, on the same exact way.
They want just give them pandas and they're happy.
That's dope, man.
As I walked around Soul Factory, it was obvious that there were multiple different types of vendors. There were some tables that only had some vintage hype and heat, and then there were some other tables that were only carrying some of the more recently popular items on the resale market, such as Yeezy slides and foam runners. Other tables were carrying some more recently released hype and GRs, and then there were even some tables that were carrying some trading cards, sports cards, vintage, streetwear, and even some customized stuff. It was really cool to see the overall selection of both apparel and sneakers that were available at this event. Some stands even had some unreleased kicks like this one, which had some of the orange lobster Nike SB dunks. As I began walking back over to my stand, I found a custom sneaker stand as well.
SS Custom Shoes. Check them out. Very nice. So who does the work? Tell us a little bit about it.
I'm an artist. I make custom shoes. Whatever design you'd like on it, I can make it for you.
And just some examples right here.
Some examples right there. I got the pictures right there.
So early in the day, there were a lot of sales at the booths around me for vendors buying off of other vendors and resellers buying off of vendors that were there. I ended up making some really good connections and even got interviewed, but I wasn't selling anything early on in the day.
It's about 1 o'clock right now, and we are an hour into Soul Factory.
traffic's a little bit slow, to be honest with you. It's we've had a bunch of people come through. It's been nice to chop it up with a bunch of people. We've had a lot of interest on the customs, obviously a lot of interest on the Oregon 8s. I'm hoping that it'll pick up and we'll sell a pair or two before we get out of here. I'll show you guys around right quick though so you can see what it looks like.
So you can tell that there is some light customer traffic, but take a look and notice that some of the tables are empty and the alleyways are pretty empty as well.
So yeah, definitely a different scene than it is at like a God Soul or a sneaker con or something like that. I guess we're gonna see what happens, see if we can sell a few pairs and just kind of see what the day has in store for us.
So I stepped away from the booth just to kind of get an idea of what it felt like not being behind the booth. And it just seemed like everybody was pretty slow at their booths, unfortunately. Even about 2 hours into the show, some of the tables weren't filled up.
So I just haggled with an 8-year-old over Pokemon card prices for about 25 minutes. That was glorious. Ended up buying a couple cards though. He got a Charizard V-Star. I'm not gonna lie, I was a little bit upset selling that Charizard. It's the only Zard that I've cracked in a pack since like 2000. That's kind of sad. Actually, I don't even know if I've ever cracked a Charizard in a pack besides that one. Still kind of slow here, but we're having a good time. I'm about to go get some energy drinks, so I might as well take some footage.
About halfway through the day, sometimes you just gotta recharge, and luckily this event was sponsored by Monster.
Are these for you to grab?
Yeah.
Oh, let's go!
The original and also the new pineapple one.
Can I grab one of each?
Rock on, man.
Thank you, boss. Appreciate it.
After fueling up on some Monster, I decided to take another lap around just to make sure that I wasn't missing anything at the event. It seemed like everything was still moving pretty slowly, and even people that had brought in carts were setting up at the empty tables that hadn't been sold to vendors. Throughout the majority of the event, it seemed like it was a lot of resellers and vendors buying off of the other vendors. And I will admit that if you owned a shop, this probably would have been a great event to attend to pick up some inventory. After a few hours, at about 3:30 or so, they decided to host an award ceremony.
Cosmetics Design to be on the building, y'all can come over here and accept your award. Cosmetics Design, I'm sorry. You know I can't read, I'm a little dyslexic, guys, I'm sorry about that. Everybody give my man a round of applause. Best vendor table, go check him out. Going out right here. We got best heat on feet. We seen some crazy things out here. We seen one shoe on this person's foot and this person's foot only. So this one has to go to Scott from YSP with the Dorm Becker Fours. I gotta give my man a little drink right here.
It's a big shot, it's a big shot. Take that pick right there. My man out here winning.
Last and final trophy is gonna be the best outfit award. I don't think y'all came correct. The best outfit award goes to our cameraman, Nico, going crazy with the fit.
With the milk and cookie shirt, man. You don't even know how much this shirt worth.
Get my man with some Monster too. Here's a shot from my boy. I don't know if you fuck with Monster, but you do today. I got some socks for y'all. Everybody want some socks? Come to the front of the stage. I got some free socks for y'all.
That was 100% the best part of this vlog. Soul Factory 2022, Boston. We haven't sold any shoes today. We sold a couple of Pokemon cards, and I bought even more Pokemon cards. We're here with an hour and a half left in the day, and we're hoping to close out on a strong note.
So it was kind of funny to have an award ceremony at a small show like this, but it was still pretty entertaining, and all of the attendees seemed to really get a kick out of it. I was really confused as to why House of Bricks gave out a couple of pairs of fake shoes, but I think that they were filming some sort of skit because I saw all of them laughing about it afterwards, so I don't think it was anything that was to be taken seriously. At any rate, kind of a cool topper to the show. It just would have been even cooler if it was more busy.
About does it for Soul Factory. Very slow day. Not a single pair of kicks sold, unfortunately. We did sell 3 raw Pokemon cards and then 2 more cards in a pack to another gentleman that came through. Then I purchased a digital business card thing, which was cool. And then somebody came through and sold me 4 ETBs for $100. I ended up spending a whole bunch more money than I made today. Definitely a learning experience. A little bit of a slower day, but still a good vibe. We had some cool neighbors by our sides and met some cool people. But that will do it for this convention vlog. I want to hear if any of you guys attended Soul Factory for this show or have been to Soul Factory in the past. Tell me what you thought about it in the comments below. Make sure to take 10 extra seconds to hit the like button and the subscribe button. And you know, you can always check out the website at www.sailboatsupplies.xyz or Sailboat Supplies on social media. Thank you guys for everybody that tuned in until the cold, bitter end. You guys already know I'm Sailboat. I'm out of here.